Hey traders, Todd Gordon here with TradingAnalysis.com. I want to update you guys on this crazy volatility here. First, I want to go back and kind of set up why we're seeing this much volatility with a video that we did back on, May 19th. So I'll link you to the video coming up here in a second. And you can go back and review it. But basically, we've met and tested some really key price and time levels in the S&P. And that's why we're seeing so much volatility. So I'll just handicap this S&P chart on the monthly real quick for you. If you take distance from the February 2000 high, compare that to the October 2000 high, that was 91 bars or 390 weeks. If you project that forward from the pre-credit crisis high, that 100% level was May of 2015. So key level, you know, we're talking 8 years later. On top of that, as I described in that video back a couple months ago, if you go down from the low here, this was the low in the market October 2002 post-NASDAQ crash. Compare that to post-credit crisis crash. That was 77 bars or 330 weeks. Project that forward. That gives you August 2015. So it's some really key timing. And also, it was the 1.618 extension of the C wave at 2139. The high was like 2134, and now we're at 1867. So price and time came together, guys. So are we going to crash? No, I don't think so. Here's the Russell, and here's how far I think we can go. All right, I'm going to give this kind of count the benefit of the doubt here. You know, I think we are in a fourth wave pullback here in the markets. This is a little bit more conservative. I am tracking another scenario that takes us lower. It is a fourth wave, but a larger degree, which means more losses. But let's take it one step at a time. This is the Russell, and I think this pullback can be compared against the pullback in March 2012 to May 2012. The key price and time support for this pullback in the Russell is going to be one of two places. It's either going to be 1132 to 1116. We'll call that Fib support zone one. And let me just kind of highlight that. It looks like we're going to push through that and then get through the next support zone, which is going to be right around 1070 to 1017, which sandwiches a key 38% price retracement at 1041. And we also have the prior low, which is a fourth wave of a low degree from October 2014. So what the hell does all that mean? That means if we don't hold 1116, I think we're going to get down to 1040 area, give or take about 25 to 30 points. And there's a chance we bounce there. An ideal timing zone for that, 100% relationship of this correction in wave four compared to the correction of the same degree, kind of the same family. 100% time comparison will be September 2nd. 1.618 is October 12th and possibly out as late as November 8th. So altogether, what that means, guys, is I think the ideal timing and price low for the Russell would be right around 1040 in late September to mid-October. Okay, so I don't think the bottom is completely falling out here. It's going to be volatile. And in fact, there's great range bound strategies that we can play here. Post wave three, high volatility environment. And then the first pullback obviously is going to raise up the volatility. And I think we're set for some sideways range action here for some period of time. It could take us into the end of the year. So we're going to be looking to focus on kind of like iron condors and other short premium, short implied volatility strategies as the market most likely moves sideways. All right, guys, so that'll do it. We do have Trading Nation tomorrow. That's CNBC.com. 1 o'clock, I'll be hosting that show every Wednesday. If this video was a help for you, go ahead and hit the like button in the YouTube window if you don't mind. That would help us rise up in the very competitive community that is YouTube and get this content out there. And I look forward to seeing you next video. See you guys.